Hi guys, Mike from CCTV Camera Pros here. In this video, I'm gonna do some testing with our new Viewtron 4 megapixel LPR camera. It's that bullet camera that you see behind me. And if you've watched some of my other license plate recognition videos before, that's a familiar sight because that's where we've had our 2 megapixel model mounted for like the last 3 years. The big differences between this new LPR camera and the existing 2 megapixel model, besides this being twice the resolution at 4 megapixel versus 2, is this has an 8 to 32 millimeter motorized varifocal lens, whereas our 1080p model is 7 to 22 millimeters. So this has a effective license plate recognition range of between 20 and 90 feet, whereas the 1080p model only goes up to about 60 or 70 feet. And today I'm gonna do some testing with the lens set at the widest angle, the 8 millimeter setting, and I'm gonna set up the license plate detection zone on the Viewtron NVR about 40 feet away from where the camera is mounted. And I'm not gonna do any license plate matching in this video where you match the detected plate number with like an authorized list in the database. I'll do that in another video later on this week. In this video, I'm just gonna teach you how to set up the license plate detection zone and show you how well the license plate detection works and how easy it is to go back and view all the license plate detection events. So first thing I'm going to do here is configure the license plate detection zone on the NVR. This is the Viewtron LPR camera right here. And then to access the settings, I'm using the mouse connected to the NVR, and I select settings from this menu, and then up here in the AI event section, select LPR. On the LPR screen, you select the LPR camera that you're going to work with. Ours was already selected, but I just want to show you that drop down, and click Enable on this detection screen. So then what you do down here is you draw the license plate detection zone. So I'm drawing a box that extends roughly like 25 feet in front of the camera to about 40 feet, like where my car is parked on the right, the front of my car is about 40 feet away. If I enable that display range, you can see this is basically the range of the license plate sizes that you're expecting to come through that zone. So I have my car parked there intentionally so I can size up how big the plates are gonna be when they come through the zone. And you wanna be fairly accurate here with your range. So I set mine from 5 to 10 based on the visual of my license plate there. And on this drop down, obviously I'm in North America and I'm in the United States of America. So I select those and the schedule I want around the clock. And then I could set up license plate recognition, but I'm not gonna do that in this video. I'll cover that in another video. So I press apply there and then I can close this window out. And then I'm back at the live view of the LPR camera. And this icon here enables the visualization of the AI object detection events. In this case, it's the license plate detection and license plate recognition. And I'm gonna jump the video forward a little bit here because I have to go around the building. So I sped things up and cut the video there a little bit. You'll see me coming around the corner right now. And then as I approach that license plate detection and license plate recognition zone, you'll see that the automated license plate recognition software on the Viewtron NVR properly detects my license plate. So that was license plate detection. It detected the license plate came into view, but you'll also notice that it accurately identified the numbers and letters on my plates. That's the ALPR software, automated license plate recognition software they're working on the camera to actually identify the plate numbers and letters. Next, I want to switch from the front license plate detection to rear. So I'm going to go back into the LPR configuration. And under this advanced section, you'll see right here, I'm going to change it to recognize when approaching to recognizing when driving away. Because in Florida, actually, we only have rear plates. So I want to switch it to rear plate detection. I'm going to apply those settings. and close this out and go back to the live view of the LPR camera again. I'm going to enable the LPR detection visualization over there on the right. And then here I drive by going the other direction, and you could see the rear plate detection is just as accurate as front plate detection. And you can do both. I mean, all states obviously have rear detection, but some also have front detection, front license plates as well. So next, I want to show you how easy it is to go and play back all the license plate detection events. So if I select Intelligent Analytics from the main menu, and then I'm going to select the LPR camera from this menu right here, and then the type of event, I'm going to select plate detection. And I already selected today for the date. I'm going to select search. This will display a thumbnail image of all the license plate detection events. And if you click on any of the thumbnail images, it'll play the video back in that little player in the lower left. And if I want full screen playback, I click that playback button. And then you have these player controls where you can go in forward and in reverse and then pause the video. I'll pause there and zoom in so you can see how clear the license plate is. And then I'll unpause it. And when I'm done, you can exit out of the player by clicking this X button in the lower right. And then I'm going to do a search again and play back the video of the license plate detection when I drove away from the LPR camera. So the rear license plate detection. So here's the video player again. And again, I'll just pause it and then rewind it again and then pause it when the license plate is in the clear view. And you could see the rear license plate detection is just as clear as the front. And then again, when I'm done, I click that X in the lower right, and then I can close out the search screen, and then I'm back at the live view of the LPR camera.
Guys, I hope this video has been helpful. And although we just launched the 4-megapixel version of our Viewtron LPR camera, the 2-megapixel version has been out for many years, and it's hugely successful. And we've actually been testing the 4-megapixel LPR back here on our pole behind our warehouse for like the past 7 or 8 months. We've been testing it before it was ready to be released. And we have it connected to this wireless access point on this pole, along with those two overview cameras that you see mounted up high, the LPR camera and the two 4K resolution Viewtron AI cameras that are doing the overview. They are connected to a network switch, and all three of those cameras are transmitting that signal back to the receiving antenna that's mounted on our warehouse over there in the distance. Anyways, if you want to learn more about our Viewtron license plate recognition cameras and more about this wireless setup we have on this pole, I have a whole bunch of demo videos on the website, as well as setup instructions for different scenarios on how to use the license plate detection and automatic license plate recognition software built into these Viewtron cameras and integrated into the Viewtron NVRs. You can see all of it at www.cctvcamerapros.com/LPR. If you have any questions for me, you can always reach out via email. I can be reached directly at mike@cctvcamerapros.net. Thank you for watching.